So TDS meter is something with which we can identify the TDS of your normal home water.
Okay, so this is the TDS meter. So it has a logo, that TDS meter. Down there are three buttons: one hold button, temperature button, and on off button. Temperature, I guess, is the shows the temperature of the water, and hold is like after getting the TDS, if you want to hold the value on the display, you can like press the hold button, which will hold the TDS readings. So okay, for testing the TDS, what we have to do is whichever water you are planning to purify. So okay, actually I have a tap here, so I want to know the TDS of this water. So open the pipe, just collect a bit of water in the cap which they have provided. After that, turn on the TDS meter and dip it on the water. So now we can see the TDS of my water is 150. Okay, according to Amazon, if the TDS is less than 200, you can use a UV or UF based purifier. The TDS is greater than 200, you have to use a RO based purifier. RO means reverse osmosis. So if the TDS is greater than 2000, a domestic purifier cannot be used, which need a treatment plan or something. So it's a good idea to buy a TDS meter before you plan to buy a purifier, because each water is different and every purifier can't be used in all water. So as if my purifier is less than 200, the unit, like 200 TDS is less than 200, so I can use this one. So it's gravity based. So that's it, guys. Just like that, I made the video, because even before this, I also didn't have any idea about this TDS thing. So before buying a purifier, just don't randomly go for RO, because if your TDS is less than 200, you doesn't have to go for RO purifier, which costs electricity also and lot of wastage of water also happen. So just select the purifier which is ideal for your TDS. Okay, thank you so much for watching. Hope you guys like the video, it's helped you guys. If you liked it, please like and subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. Take care.